almost $750 million, that's P as in boy, every 2 weeks in lost wages. And that's because, you know, we have, it's yin and yang, it's good and bad that we're linked to the federal government because it's so helpful for our economy. But when the government does, as you say, act irrationally and just go off the rails and say, oh, we're going to shut it down, that's a big problem for Maryland that other states do not have to face.
That is Controller Peter Francho on the C4 show today, talking about the impact of the 24-day-old partial government shutdown, about $750 million in lost wages over the last 3 weeks. Also, about 172,000 either federal workers or federal contractors.
Right.
And that's the biggest impact.
We don't talk about the contractor part, but we talk about the 800,000 people affected, some half of those, 400,000.
And those workers are going to get their back pay.
They
presumably
voted on
President
week.
Trump signs the bill as he promises to do, sponsored by Senators Cardin and Van Hollen.
And the thing is, Robert, you know, what most people are frustrated with right now, particularly after paychecks went out on Friday with a $0 amount in there, whether it was direct deposit or whatever, is the fact that you have members of Congress still being paid. I'm going to repeat that again. You have members of Congress that went to Puerto Rico for a Hamilton show over the weekend. You have the Senate and the House that adjourned. Where is the urgency? Where is the crisis moment to get these 800,000 people their money that are still working, many of them?
Look, Phil Yakubowski was at BWI Marshall today, where there was a news conference that Senator Cardin did. He's been doing this around the state, different federal workers, air traffic controllers, and TSA employees. He asked a bunch of passengers, you know, how's this impacting you? Say, not much, you know, I can sympathize with them. And airport officials say, so far, things are okay.
Yeah, but Robert, let's look at Houston and Miami. You have two TSA locations, one in Houston, one in Miami, that have closed down. You have a terminal in Miami that's actually closed down. Those are the largest airports in both cities in Houston and in Miami. The bottom line is it'll impact more. The longer this goes on, and particularly in the transportation realm, you're going to see it. You're already seeing it when it comes to food stamps, things like that. At the end of the month, those will be impacted. Payments that go out to other federal agencies, it'll accumulate as days move forward.
And so Republican members of Congress, Democratic members of Congress, hopefully will be pressured into resolving this.
Well, they look dug in right now, Robin. For the president today to come out and say, after Lindsey Graham, his, I call him BFF, United States Senator Lindsey Graham, who's very close to the president, he said, reopen the government for 3 weeks. Then if, Mr. President, there's no negotiation with Democrats, then do the National Emergency Act. The president said no to that. So if both sides are dug in, Robert, I'm not sure how this ends.
Another topic you talked about today, and it's been an ongoing topic, is arming Baltimore City school police officers. This bill has been introduced. I guess it gets a caucus vote next week sometime.
Delegate Cheryl Glenn.
Glenn, the lead sponsor, is the chairman of the city delegation in the House. Is there any momentum for this? I mean, I know.
I don't know, Robert.
Yeah.
It's amazing to think that of all 24 jurisdictions in the state, Baltimore City is the only one that does not allow its trained police officers that are in schools.
These are police officers who undergo the same training as Baltimore City
police officers. Now, here's one real thing to think about as we're debating whether to give them this power that they had, by the way, from 2000 or whatever to 2015, and because of a quirk in the language that was taken away from them.
Right.
You have officers, Robert, that during an assembly, according to Sergeant Clyde Boatwright, the president of the Union for School Police Officers, at 11 a.m. they can have a gun on them in an assembly in an auditorium, but they have to take that gun off to walk through the rest of the building. What kind of sense does the application of that law make, particularly when it comes to public safety? And by the way, Robert, six guns have been taken off of children this year, students in Baltimore City Public Schools, by unarmed school police officers.
All right, to be continued. The C4 Show back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.